click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, we have seen in the analysis of the heat exchanger the role of LMTD method, that is the log mean temperature difference method. Now let us solve a problem based on that. It's a numerical on LMTD method. Let us read the numerical. The numerical says the flow rate of hot and cold water streams running through a parallel flow heat exchanger. So the one thing that one need to understand is they have given us a parallel flow heat exchanger. So they have given that for the parallel flow heat exchanger are 0.2 kg per second and 0.5 kg per second. So they have given us the mass flow rate of hot and cold water. The inlet temperatures on the hot and cold sides are 75 degrees Celsius and 20 degrees Celsius respectively. The exit temperature of hot water is 45 degrees Celsius. If the individual heat transfer coefficient on both sides are 650 watt per meter square degree Celsius, calculate the area of heat exchanger. Now this was a question which was asked in May 13 in the University of Mumbai. Now let us try and attempting the same problem. For that, let us start drawing a schematic diagram. So they have given us a heat exchanger. Let us draw a heat exchanger. Let us say this way, let's say a cold fluid is flowing, and then so these are my heat exchanger. From here the hot fluid is flowing. So let me write, this is a cold fluid and this is a hot fluid. Let us draw the temperature versus X diagram for the same. So this is temperature, this is X. So till length L, the inlet temperature is, let's say, THI, that is the hot water inlet temperature, and the exit temperature is, let's say, THO. Now since this is the parallel flow heat exchanger, the diagram will look something like this, where this is TCI, this is TCO. So H stands for hot fluid, C stands for cold fluid, I stands for inlet, and O stands for the outlet of the flow. Now with this thing in our mind, let us write down the data. Now what data they have given us? Let us see, the data that they have given is for the hot fluid, MH is 0.2 kg per second, then MC is given as 0.5 kg per second. So they have given us the mass flow rate of hot and cold fluid. Similarly, they have given us the temperature, that is the inlet temperature of hot fluid is 75 degrees Celsius and the exit temperature of hot fluid is, so this is the inlet temperature of cold fluid, that is 20 degrees Celsius. Apart from this, they have also given us the exit temperature of the hot fluid. So THO they have given as 45 degrees Celsius. Now with this thing in our mind, along with this temperatures and the mass flow rate, they have also given us the value of H, I and HO, and they have said that the heat transfer coefficient for the inlet surface and the exit surface is 650 watt per meter square degree Celsius. Now these are the things that they have given, and along with that, what they are asking us, they are asking us to find out the surface area. So area is what they are asking us to find out. Now in this problem, as we have seen, we know out of four, three temperatures. So if we know at least three temperatures out of four, we can easily go for the LMTD method. So let us start solving the problem using the LMTD method. The basic assumptions for this problem is the heat transfer is only conduction and convection. Now we are trying to write down the assumptions. Then the next assumption is, see, the heat will only be transferred in one direction. So there is no heat transfer in the x direction. So heat transfer is only in one direction. Then there is no heat generation and the steady state is assumed. Apart from that, all the properties such as the value of H, thermal conductivity and the overall heat transfer coefficient, they are all constants. So they are not a function of X, Y, Z or time or the temperature. Now these are the few of the important assumptions. So keeping these assumptions in our mind, what we have come up is the LMTD method. Now let us try and apply the LMTD method. Before this, we can equate by the energy balance method, we can equate the amount of heat that is supplied by the hot fluid and the amount of heat that is absorbed by the cold fluid. Now let us start doing that. So if suppose Q dash of C is the amount of heat gained by the cold fluid, then this can be written as m dot h cph into thi minus tho. So they have given us the hot fluid temperatures, so let us write down those. So with this information we can write the value of Q dash as, the m dot of h is given as 0.2, then the Cp of n. So the Cp value for the water is generally considered as 4.19, or you can even take this as 4.2 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So this we will keep in our mind. And then, so now this is given for the water. And now we can use it for the hot and cold fluid as well. So let us use that. So this is 4.19. Let us convert this kilojoule into joule itself. Now this is very mandatory that we need to convert kilojoule into joule. So this is the value of Cp for the hot fluid, that is water. And the temperature differences are, the hot fluid temperature is 75 and that of the cold fluid temperature is 45. So with this, the value which we are getting is 25122 watt. Now this is the amount of heat that is emitted by the hot fluid. Now the same amount of heat will be absorbed by the cold fluid. So let us write down, the same Q dash of C is given as m dot C CPC, then TCO minus TCI. Now let us put the numbers. The m dot of C is given as 0.5. This value again will be same as the previous one, 4.19 into 10^3. Then TCO is something that we don't know. So we will keep this as it is, TCO, and for the cold fluid the inlet temperature is 20. Now here, since the temperatures are only differences that we have to consider, we can either write it in terms of Kelvin or we can write it in terms of degree Celsius. So we have written here in terms of degree Celsius itself. So with this, if I put the value of QC as 25122 watt, and if I solve this, the cold fluid outlet temperature that we are getting is 32 degrees Celsius. Now here we have tried to find out all the four temperatures. Now with the knowledge of all the four temperatures, let us find out the LMTD, that is the log mean temperature difference. See, now this value is 75, this here is 45, then the inlet temperature was 20, and this we have got to was 32. So now with this thing in our mind, we can find the delta T1 and delta T2. So what are we getting? The delta T1 will be 75 minus 20, so that is 55, and delta T2 is 45 minus 32, so delta T2 will be 13. Now we can use these values to find the log mean temperature difference. So LMTD is given as delta T1 minus delta T2 upon ln of delta T1 upon delta T2. Now let us put the numbers and see what we are getting. So the delta T1 that we have got was 55 minus delta T2 was 13 divided by ln of 55 by 13. Now let us solve this, or we can simply put this in the main equation. So what is the main equation? The main equation, we know that the heat transfer rate through the solid surface from the hot fluid to the cold fluid is given as U A LMTD. Now in this, they are asking us to find out the value of A. We know the value of Q. We can equate the value of Q here with that of the Q dash of C. Now LMTD also is known. So what is the value of U here? Now for value of U, we have to answer this using the basic formula that they have given us the value of H. So we can write the value of U is 1 upon U is equal to 1 upon HI plus 1 upon HO. So both the values they have given is 165. So this is 650 upon 650. So by solving this, you should be able to get the value of U. So the value of U that we are getting is 1300 upon 650 square inverse. Now this value we will put in the main equation, then we can easily find the unknown over here. So let us do the same thing. So the value of Q dash was 25122 is equal to, this value is 650 square divided by 1300. That is the overall heat transfer coefficient into area, which we don't know. This is what we need to find out, and the LMTD. LMTD, as we have seen, it is 55 minus 13 upon ln of 55 upon 13. Now, in this, the only unknown should be A. So, obviously, by putting everything in the calculator, I can find the value of A, and it's coming as 2.65. Now that should be it. They are asking us to find out the value of area in this case, and we have tried to successfully find out that area, and we are getting this at around 2.65 meter square. Now that is it in this topic. Thank you for watching this video. Please stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda. Thank you.